Now, while the entire Brexit Leave campaign might seem like a marketing gimmick done really well on the face of it, is there something deeper going on at the heart of all the brouhaha? 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 Is that how you say it? I love that word. I'm the guy in glasses, and today we're talking about one of my favorite topics of late, Brexit. Don't worry, baby. Just call my name. I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to. Besides having a childhood fascination towards the British accent, I also have another vested interest in keeping a close eye on the Brexit happenings. As a content strategist, I'm eager to keep a track of the growing power of media manipulation and the polarizing effects it has on democracy politics. If Brexit happened a few years earlier, I would have been calling it one of the most polarized issues of modern times. But today, total polarization seems to be the theme of global politics these days. If you support Brexit, you're an ignorant hick. If you support Donald Trump, it means you support the Nazis. If you support Modi, it means you also support the brutal killings of Muslims. It's fitting to me that the HBO special on the entire Vote Leave campaign carried out by Dominic Cummings and his associates garnered such varying reactions. Because when you have both sides of the table accusing the other of fear-mongering, and when it turns out that both sides have valid reasons to be making this claim, there's something to think about. Which way is the fear-mongering really happening? Is the fear-mongering being done by the people who are claiming that the UK is doomed now that it's got itself out of a glorified trade union? Or was it fear-mongering when people were claiming that the European Union had ruined the sovereignty of the United Kingdom? Identity, no identity, who cares? Part of a nation, part of a union, who cares? But I do care about the dark consequences of such polarized politics, because it leads to certain other philosophical problems, something much deeper than just the marketing campaigns put together by a few men. Let me try to postulate this problem in the best way that I can. Let's start with an axiom. The axiom I'm assuming is as follows. The advent and rise of social media has made it reasonably simple for an intelligent marketing planner to definitely manipulate the feelings and viewpoints of an average person in the world today. Now, if you don't hold this axiom to be true, then the rest of my argument is going to be baseless, so you can walk out of this video right now. But if you, like me, hold this axiom to be true, then we can continue trying to postulate the problem that I see. Now, if you agree that a marketing plan with modern communication channels like social media has the ability to severely change the feelings, viewpoints, decisions, and allegiances of a person, then the idea of manipulating an entire country to think a certain way seems to be only a matter of volume. A matter of scale, if you will, and that is what Dominic Cummings, amongst others, recognized. However, what the Leave campaigners did not recognize is the polarizing effects that this campaign would have in the country, and what monsters would be released as a result of that. The monster of political doubt. Here's a question. Does it sometimes feel like people want Brexit negotiations to fail so that they can feel victorious? And if that's the case, then doesn't that mean that these people value their political identities more than what the United Kingdom stands for? It's the exact same question as, do people want Donald Trump's presidency to fail? Do people want Modi's governance to fail? Hard to get an answer to these questions, because the answers don't exist. Let me explain why. I'll tell you why an opposing political viewpoint today seems like a virus that is growing out of control and has to be squashed, or destroyed, or cured, whatever it is that you do with viruses. Now, is this what the original democratic thinkers had envisioned? No. The reason why modern democracies have started spawning such polarizing politics, where contrary viewpoint advocates want each other's extinction rather than cooperation, is because of the power of media manipulation these days. Channels of communications have evolved to such sophisticated levels today that it becomes easy for clever marketers to conduct mass manipulations and shifts in public opinion. Now, if you watch Benedict Cumberbatch's Brexit, The Uncivil War, you might be better suited to understand some of the more darker consequences of such fear campaigns that he so strategically conducted. Identity politics is a double-edged sword, because while identity politics guarantees that you are the heroes to some, it also simultaneously guarantees that you are the villain to some. Give me your thoughts on HBO's new feature, Brexit, The Uncivil War, in your comments below. I will be keeping you guys posted about anything and everything Brexit in my videos this year. Before I end, I'd also like to point out that there's going to be a parliamentary debate that is going to be conducted on the 14th of January, which is Monday, day after tomorrow, on the topic, grant a people's vote if Parliament rejects the EU withdrawal agreement. This debate is thanks to the Petitions Committee in the UK, who manage countrywide petitions. And if any of these petitions manage to get signed by 100,000 signatures, then the Parliament is required by law to conduct a debate on the matter. And the Parliament will be using this occasion to also discuss petitions that got close to 100,000 but didn't quite touch that number. I'll leave a list of these topics that they are going to cover in this debate in the description below. And then I'll be back on Monday with my thoughts on how the discussion got together, how the parliamentary debate took place, and was there anything that came out of it. Until then, I'm the guy in glasses. I think about it, so you don't have to.